body kind of becomes unimportant. The body is at ease and really relaxed in a nice posture. And remember, meditation does not really depend on the posture. The posture is not that important. As long as you are at ease and you are relaxed, that is what matters. And you find people doing meditation in all kinds of ways. Sitting cross-legged, sitting on a chair, lying down, walking, of course. And there's only one posture, as I like to say, that we do not recommend, and that is standing on your head. If you stand on your head, you have a problem. Otherwise, any posture is fine. As long as you are at ease, as long as you find the middle way of the Buddha. So just get ready and settle down, close your eyes, and relax. And for the meditation to work, the attitude is so important. It's important that you relate to the meditation in the right way. And one of the most important things is not to try to do the meditation, but to allow the meditation to happen all by itself. And there's different ways of getting into this kind of attitude. And one of the very useful ways is to imagine yourself that you have come to the end of your life, that you're lying on your deathbed, that your death is not very far away, maybe only a few hours away. That kind of attitude tells you what you are supposed to do in meditation practice. Meditation is similar to dying in the sense that when you die, you have to let go. In meditation also, we try to let go. So get into that death mood, what it feels like when you're dying. And what it feels like is that you tend to be really relaxed, really at ease. You don't do anything. You don't try to control the mind. You don't try to hold on to the breath. But you relax and you enjoy the journey. In the same way, in meditation practice, just relax, enjoy the journey. Know that you have to let go of everything in the world. But apart from that, all you do is relax and just be at ease. And as you calm down in the meditation, as you let go of the past and the future, as your mind becomes a bit more peaceful, remember to try to bring some positive feelings into the mind. And one way of doing that is to have a sense of gratitude for all the marvelous things in your life. And here you are, you have the teachings of the Buddha, the Dhamma at your side, and you have all these Kalyanamitas, and you have found this marvelous path of Buddhist practice, this path which leads in one way only, towards greater happiness, contentment and peace, and away from the problems of the world. What a wonderful thing it is to have found a path like this. Rejoice in that. Bring that sense of elation and joy into your practice to make the mind brighter and more beautiful and more conducive to peace and calm.
Okay, so coming to the end of the meditation, and before we come to the end, just take a few moments as usual, just to reflect back. How do you feel now? And if you do feel a bit more at ease, a bit more calm, ask yourself why that is the case. Okay, everyone, let's take a break and we'll see you back again at 9 o'clock.